गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर चिल्ड्रेन, इट्स मी विद्या, यू आर एस एस टीचर. दिस इज अवर सेकेंड क्लास एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर. अप टू दिस वी कम्प्लीटेड हिस्ट्री वन चैप्टर, जियोग्राफी वन चैप्टर एंड पॉलिटिक्स वन चैप्टर एंड हिस्ट्री. लास्ट वी कम्प्लीटेड द हिस्ट्री चैप्टर. विच चैप्टर वी कम्प्लीटेड? यस, चैप्टर वन, when, where and how. And in that chapter we started to study about the medieval period, and in that chapter we already told about the political condition of India in medieval period, and in that we mentioned about three new kingdoms emerged at that time. Now we are going to study about that three kingdom and what is the condition of that time in India under this three kingdom. That everything we are going to study in this chapter. This is our history second chapter, new kings and kingdom. New kings and kingdoms. Okay, last chapter we already mentioned about these three new kings, so you know that who are they. And here we can start the class, that period between 700 CE to 12,000 CE, we can witness that there is emergence of many new kingdoms, and in that may the three new kingdoms become more important and popularized. And that three, we are going to study about that three kingdom and emergence of these three kingdom, what happened in the political situation. We can say that there is a big change in the state structure of empires in from the ancient period. We can see because of the by the emergence of these three new kingdoms, we can see that there is a big change in the in the state structures of the empires from the ancient period. Okay, we can see a big administrative changes in from this ancient period. In medieval period there is a big change, or there is a difference we can see in the state affairs. Okay, then next we are going to study about the rise of this regional kingdoms, and here three major kingdoms emerged in this time. We told this many times, three major kingdoms, and that are, one is Palas. This is one kingdom this Palas in eastern India. Palas in eastern India. Then next one, Gujara Pratiharas. In western India, and Gangetic Plains. The Gangetic Plains means this plains formed in the banks of Ganga river, that is Gangetic Plains and western India. Gujara Pratiharas emerged in western India and Gangetic Plains, and Palas, they emerged in eastern India. Then one more is it is Rashtrakoodas in Deccan and southern India. Deccan and southern India. Deccan and southern India. Rashtrakoodas in Deccan and southern India. So we are studying about these three new kingdoms. It is Palas were they were the kingdom. This kingdom was emerged in eastern India. Gujara Pradiharas they were emerged in western India and Gangetic plains, and Rashtrakutas they were emerged in Deccan and southern India. So whole India, these three kingdoms were most important, and here these three kingdoms are most important. And another one similarity between these three kingdoms was, and these three kingdom always struggled for the supremacy of Kanauj. Kanauj is a main place at that. Then you will think about, you will think, what is the importance of this place? This is a place, Kanauj is a place, and why this three kingdoms always struggle for the supremacy of Kanauj. Next we are going to study what is the importance of Kanauj. Do you understand these all things? The three kingdoms and what are they, everything. Okay, next we are going to study what is the importance of Kanauj at that time. Kanauj is a place in India. Kanauj is a place in India, and what is the importance of that place? Now you just think about that, why this three kingdoms is always struggle for the supremacy of Kanauj. Listen, Kanauj was strategically linked with all the trade routes. Kanauj was strategically linked with all the trade routes going towards the eastwards and Gangetic plains. And all the trade routes are going through the Kanauj, and Kanauj was the trading center at that time. That's why what happened, all the kingdoms and all the kings in India, they are always looking at Kanauj. When they, if they get the supremacy or power of Kanauj, they will become the most powerful king in that time. That's why all these three kingdoms, they are struggled to get the supremacy of Kanauj. Understood all of you? Okay, very good. So we told about three kingdoms and what, why these three kingdoms was always struggle for the supremacy of Kanauj. Then next we can move to the different three kingdoms, how they struggled that everything. First we can study about Palas. We can study about Palas. Palas were, we already told, Palas from, or they emerged in eastern India. They emerged in eastern India. Then eastern India and extended to Bihar and Palas in eastern India and extended to Bihar and Bengal. And founder of Pala dynasty, it is King Gopala. Founder of Pala dynasty, name is King Gopala. And according to a Tibetan monk, his name is Taranada. Gopala was selected by the local leaders in the 8th century. See, here we told about Palas. Palas in eastern India, and they extended their territory into Bihar and Bengal. Then the founder of Pala dynasty is the founder of Pala dynasty was King Gopala. Next, we told King Gopala was elected by the local leaders of 8th century CE. That told by one Tibetan monk. His name is Taranath. Got it? About King Gopala. Okay, one more time I will say. It is first kingdom Palas. Palas emerged in eastern India, extended their territory into Bihar and Bengal, and the founder of Pala dynasty, it is King Gopala. And according to a Tibetan monk Taranath, this King Gopala was elected by the local leaders of 8th century CE. Okay, then next king in Pala dynasty, it is King Dharmapala. It is King Dharmapala, and he made the Pala kingdom very strong, and he was the strongest king at that time. And in the end of 8th century, Dharmapala led a successful campaign and conquered Kannauj. Dharmapala was the strongest king at that time, and he made a successful campaign and conquered the Kannauj from the Pratiharas. Then after that, we need to study about Dharmapala. He was the person who made the famous University of Vikramashila. He was the king who made the famous University Vikramashila. Okay, then about King Dharmapala. Dharmapala was the most strongest king in this Pala dynasty or Pala kingdom, and at the end of the 8th century, what he did? He led a successful campaign and conquered the Kannauj from the Pratiharas. Then next one important thing about King Dharmapala, it is he was the founder of which university? Yes, Vikramashila University is very famous at that time. Vikramashila University was founded by whom? Yes, King Dharmapala. Then next important king from this Pala dynasty, it is King Devapala. King Devapala, the next important king from the Pala dynasty, it is King Devapala, and he was the person who extended the borders of his kingdom to Assam. Devapala is the person who extended the borders of his kingdom into Assam. When the historians are telling about this Pala dynasty, the most famous thing they are, most important thing they are telling about them is they are the people who made or who built the Mahabodhi temple at Bodh Gaya. These Palas are the people, those who made or built the Mahabodhi temple at Bodh Gaya. Okay, and about Palas we completed. I will tell you one more time. Palas are the one of the new kingdom emerged in medieval period, and they from eastern India and Bihar and Bengal, they extended their border to Bihar and Bengal. Then after that, we told about the founder of Pala dynasty. It is King Gopala, and he was the ruler who elected by the local leaders of 8th century CE. Then next king we told the most strongest king in Pala dynasty. It is King Dharmapala. Dharmapala was the most strongest king that we told, and he was the person who made or who led a successful campaign and conquered the Kannauj. First itself I told these all kingdoms, they are always looking to the Kannauj to conquer and made their territory, and here Dharmapala was the king who conquered Kannauj at the end of the 8th century CE from the Pratiharas. Then next important thing I told about Dharmapala is he was the person who built the famous university Vikramashila. Okay, then next king Devapala, and he was the person who extended his kingdom to Assam. Okay, then another one thing, the most important thing I told you, that this Pala, then about this Pala dynasty, the Pala rulers, they were the people, those who built the Mahabodhi temple at Bodh Gaya. Understood all of you? Okay, can we move to the next kingdom? Good. Next kingdom, which one is that? Yes, Gujara Pratiharas. Next kingdom is Gujara Pratiharas. Pratiharas. Don't worry about the names. I already told you, read the textbook, then you will get all these names very easily. Okay. Gujara Pratiharas. Next kingdom is Gujara Pratiharas, and these people from what? These kingdom in western India and Gangetic plains. Western India and Gangetic plains. So these Gujara Pratiharas, they are in western India and Gangetic plains, and they traced their origin in Hun tribes. They traced their origin in Hun tribes. Then next about them, they are the most powerful Rajput clan. They are the most powerful Rajput clan at that time. Okay. They are the most powerful Rajput clan at that time, and the first important king in Gujara Pratiharas was that Nagabhatta first was the most important Pratihara king who bravely resisted the Arab invasion. Then the next greatest ruler was Mihir Bhoja was the next famous ruler in Gujara Pratiharas, and he was the king who ruled from 836 to 886 CE. 836 to 886 CE. Mihir Bhoja was the ruler who ruled Gujara Pratiharas kingdom from 836 CE to 886 CE. And during his reign, Mihir Bhoja extended their country to the large part of Rajasthan and Malwa, and he was the strongest king in their dynasty, and he was the person who controlled Kanauj also. What we studied about Mihir Bhoja? Mihir Bhoja was the strongest king in this Gujara Pradihara's kingdom, and he ruled the country from 836 to 886 CE, and he was the king who extended their border to Rajasthan and Malwa and controlled the Kanauj. Okay, and up to we studied about the second kingdom, it is Gujara Pradiharas. They are in western India and Gangetic Plains. That I already told you what is Gangetic Plains. Gangetic Plains are the plains formed in the river banks of Ganga. Okay, then these Gujara Pradiharas, they traced their origin in Hun tribe, and they were the most powerful Rajput clans at that time, and the first important king was Nagabhata first. And what we told about Nagabhata first, he was the first important Pradihara king who bravely resisted the Arab invasion, and we told about the most strongest king at that time. He was Mihir Bhoja, and Mihir Bhoja ruled the Gujara Pradihara kingdom from 836 to 886 CE, and he was the king who extended the country to Rajasthan and Malwa and controlled the Kanauj. Understood, all of you? Can we move to the next kingdom? Okay. Which is the next one? Yes, Rashtrakutas. Rashtrakutas from? Yes, they are from our place also, means southern India and Deccan. So, next one. Rashtrakutas. They are in Deccan and southern India or southern India, southern India. That is good to hear, no? Yes, Deccan and southern India. They are from Deccan and southern India, and they are the third dynasty who fought for the Kanauj. And they, what we can say about them? Yes, according to some Arab records, they were the most powerful of these three dynasties. Last two also we studied, no? They were the most powerful in these three dynasties. That is the most important thing we are studying about Rashtrakutas. That the Rashtrakutas are the third dynasty which fought for the Kanauj, and they are in Deccan and southern India. And according to the Arab records, this Rashtrakutas were the most powerful people in this three dynasties. Okay, and the founder of Rashtrakuta dynasty, that is Dandi Durga. Dandi Dandi Durga. Dandi Durga was the founder of Rashtrakuta dynasty, and he was a feudatory of Chalukya dynasty. Before that, Chalukya dynasty was there. In that Chalukya dynasty's one feudatory is this person, and his name is Dandi Durga. He was a feudatory of Chalukya dynasty, and the famous ruler two famous rulers are there, Amoghavarsha and Krishna Third. Amoghavarsha and Krishna Third were the famous rulers of Rashtrakuta dynasty and they also extended their frontier to Kanauj and the last king Kaga second last king was Kaga second. He was defeated by the later Chalukya dynasty. And how this Rashtrakutas declined, the last king Kaga second, who was defeated by the later Chalukya dynasties. Okay, so we told about that three dynasties. Last we told about the Rashtrakutas. Rashtrakutas were the most power, according to the Arab records, they were the most powerful dynasties among these three, and they are in Deccan and southern India. And the founder of Rashtrakuta dynasty is Dandi Durga, and the most important kings were Amogha Varsha and Krishna third. Then the last king was Kaga second, and he was defeated by the later Chalukya dynasty. These all about the three new kingdoms and how they fought for the Kanauj. Okay, next we are going to study about how this tripartite struggle ends. How this tripartite struggle ends means how the three dynasties struggle for Kanauj ends. Okay, and here after the capture of Kanauj by the Pratihara ruler Naghabatta II, Kanauj remained under the control of Pratiharas as a power of as the power of Palas and Rashtrakutas start to decline at that time. When the Kanauj is in the hands of Pratihara King Naghabatta II, at that time this our Palas and Rashtrakutas power started to decline. Then what happened in 9th century, and what happened, the last Pratihara ruler of Kanauj was defeated by Mahmud Ghazni in 1017. Then how this tripartite struggle ends? Yes, I will tell you one more time. Last king of Pratihara dynasty, Naghabatta II, he captured Kanauj. At that time, what was happening to that other two kingdoms, the Palas and Rashtrakutas? They are losing their strength. And they declined at that time in 9th century CE. Then the last king, then at that time Kanauj is in the hands of Gujara Pratiharas. Then the last Pratihara king, he was very weak king. That's why itself what happened, the Mahmud Ghazni, he invaded India at that time, and he captured this Kanauj from the Pratihara rulers. So for the struggle for this Kanauj is ended the. Okay, understood. Then next we can study about the decline of these three dynasties. Nothing is the main reason for the decline of these three dynasties were these, what is that, no? These three dynasties were well organized with a strong army, and they were collecting the revenue for maintaining the army. While they were busy with this conflict to control the Kanauj, what happened, the feudatories or the landowners of that countries, they become independent. So the people or the king of three dynasties, they cannot collect the revenue properly and they cannot maintain the army. That is the main reason of the decline of these three kingdoms. not clear, one more time I will tell. See, listen, I told these three kingdoms, the Palas, Rashtrakutas and Gujara Pratiharas, the three kingdoms are having a well organized strong army. How they are maintaining this army? It is very well organized and very strong, so they should have more money to maintain that. How they are maintaining? Yes, with the help of the revenue. They are collecting revenue from the commons, and with the help of that revenue they are maintaining this army. When they are busy with the struggle to get the supremacy of Kannauj, what happened? This landowners or the feudatories of the kingdom, they, what they did, they become independent countries. They become independent, and what happened? This kingdom or the center, they cannot collect the revenue from them. So they cannot maintain the army also. Then the country, what happened? These three kingdoms declined because of this reason only. Okay, all of you understood today's all portions. What all things we told? We told about the three kingdoms which emerged in the medieval period, and Palas, Rashtrakutas and Gujara Pratiharas, and they always fought for the supremacy, for supremacy of Kannauj. Then we told about the kings, important kings in both these three kingdoms, and we told about how the struggle of Kannauj, or struggle for the Kannauj, stopped, and how these three dynasties declined. And so we are going to wind up the class here. See you next class. Have a nice day. Thank you.